are sitting there with new things in your pocket. You have to be mindful of some things. And that is the third thing that I'm going out. Every new thing has an enemy. Every new thing. Some people want new things. Some people want new things,
yes, sir.
But they don't want new things in the life of others around them.
Yes, yes.
They want to be local champion.
Preach.
Only them.
Preach.
Only them. They want to. God bless you. They want to succeed.
Yes.
But they don't want to succeed more than them. They say, do this thing. So that do this thing. Do this thing. But the day they start saying that this thing that you are doing is going to carry weight than themselves, then they start showing themselves. They want to prosper, but they want to prosper. But your prosperity to be under it. If anybody like that is in your life today, enemies of new beginnings. Number one enemy of new beginning, I call it oppositors.
Okay.
Oppositors. Now, this is church, very big church. If you can do this like this, remove this and put this and add this and put this and balance it, some people say no. Even though they know that when we do that thing, it's to the glory of God, they will say no. Why? Because the idea does not come from them.
Yes.
Does
not come from them.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yes. Yeah. Does it make them die of idea?
No.
No.
Because the idea was not from them. They will say no. I told you there are enemies of new beginnings. No, I say what? Of procedures. Amen.
Amen.
Are you getting it now?
Yes. Yes.
Enemies of new beginnings. No, enemy of progress this time. Enemies of what?
New beginnings.
Do you know that at times God permits oppositors in the life of his children?
Yes. Yes.
Because at times as children of God, we are always too comfortable with our comfort zone. We don't always want to change gear because of the fear of unseen. We are just fearful. And God wants you to proceed to the next level. And at times you will allow oppositors. Oppositors are wicked. You are supposed to wage war against them. But at times God permits it to your own benefit. But there are oppositors to everything that is near. God woke that boy up that day, one day. He said, even though you are the last one of your family, he said, I'm going to use you. And that boy is left. He said, my father, I saw stars. One is a Bible scholar. She's looking for a boy. He said, I saw stars. I saw moon. I saw sun. Then sister said, bowing down for him. And his brothers, sir, his own brothers, blood brothers, will go for to oppose that dream. To oppose what?
That dream.
Oh, to oppose what?
The dream.
He goes to God and said, I have a dream. As a church, the day we stop having dreams and vision, that day we start dying. A man without a dream or a vision is a dead man.
Yes.
Those that said, I have a dream that new thing is going to begin in this family through me. And his own brothers, they stood up to oppose. They said no. Because why? That is their ministry. That is their ministry.
And he told his father.
Oh my God, he told his grandfathers.
And his brethren. And his father. In Fufu. And tell unto him. What this dream. Thou hast dreamed.
God bless you, man. God bless you, man. Even his own father stood up to rebuke him because of his dream. Because of what?
His dream.
Every enemies of your dream.
Amen.
Listen. Let me tell you the way you shout this amen. I call it a rabbalistic amen. What do I call it?
Rabbalistic.
You dare not do a rabbalistic amen while sitting. You do it rabbalistically.
Amen.
Amen. Am I speaking to someone?
Yes.
To spread the arrow of your amen around.
Yes.
I was alone today. I was watching the live stream of Redeemed Christian Church of God convention. I was alone. Live stream. And you know what, my father? They call the team Amen. Amen gets arrow. Yes. So you will not just sit there and say Amen. So that the arrow will not go to one side. You will do it propagandistically. So you will spread the arrow of Amen. Maybe that person that is opposing your dream is at the back there, the arrow will go.
Yes.
Maybe that person is in Baltimore, the arrow will go.
Yes.
Maybe that person is in New Jersey, the arrow will go. Maybe they are in California, the arrow will go. Maybe they are in Nigeria, the arrow will go. That is why you will do it what? They shall receive arrow of death. Give me out your seat. I don't want to waste time.
Rabba, rabba. Amen.
Enemy of no beginning.
Yes.
Number one is what?
Oppositor.
Let me tell you one point before I go to the next point. Oppositors do not support. Because why, sir? They don't have the anointing to support.
Yes.
You say this thing is good. Let's carry it together.
Yes.
Let's do it together. They will start somewhere and say no, no. You say oh, the house of God. There are some old things there. Let's remove. They say oh, leave it the way like the way it is. I'm asking people to support.
Yes.
Rich. They cannot support. That is their own destiny.
Rich.
They don't have the destiny to Rich. Support. They don't have the anointing to support.
Yes.
They are instruments of destruction. The Holy Spirit just told me something now. At times, even when oppositors support, when they support, they are supporting the team that is working against you.
Yes.
If they ever support in your life, they support the team that is working against you. Their job is to always oppose whoever that is opposing you. As from today, the Lord is not opposing them. Tell your neighbor. Say, tonight, no pishereshe. Number two enemy. Tell your neighbor. A new beginning. It's what accusers. Accusers.
Yes.
Daniel chapter 6, verse 4.
Daniel.
Accusers. Yes. Yes. God bless you. Hold on. I challenge every youth that is in the house. Shame on you. You are here. Mama is holding Bible before you. Little, no respect. We are the house of God. We have the kingdom of God surrounding somebody. We take it back.
By
we are supposed to be hijacking it from Mama. Mama is opening Bible faster than you. Youth, later now you go outside to redeem and we say, Select, you don't know Bible. You are here now, your Bible will be here. Shame. Read, man.
Then the president and the priest,
Father,
and person against Daniel. And then his kingdom. But they do not find nothing at a person.
God bless you, man. Because of my time, God bless you, man. I don't go there. Look at what money read. They could not find accusation. Why? Because they are what? Accusers. Somebody accuse us. Now, let me give you one or two characteristics about accusers. They raise the dust of what you have passed through. Sir, you committed a sin. You know that you committed a sin. And you ran to God. And God has forgiven you. And has told you to move on. You are moving on with your life, but accusers will always look for your mistake and errors.
Yeah.
That is accusers. They don't want you to start a new thing. Yeah. Bah! Alaba, so, want to expand his church, want to start doing this. They'll say, which Alaba? When we were in New York 10 years ago, he slept with one mama.
This woman was taking.
Mama, I declare in the mighty name of Jesus, greatness will never be removed to your family. Greatness will never leave your family. Read, ma. Mama is telling me, but I'm about to run off. Yes. Yes, ma. Yes. Okay.
Now, Moses, Lord, command us that we should stop. Then said, tempt him, and they may have a feast. But Jesus stopped down.
Jesus stopped.
And with his finger wrote on the ground, and God heard them out.
Yes, ma'am.
So when they have continued asking him, he beat up his chest and said unto them, who has not seen?
Who has not seen among you? Let him pass. That night, Jesus shut the mouth of accusers. You say, wait, Shola. O Fasiga. O Mugbo.
His words.
O Setibi. O Setong. Accusers will never talk about anything good that you have done before. They always look for a witness. Why? To stop your new beginning.
Yes, sir.
They say, oh, I so much love that man. They say, oh, which man of God? Oh, my eye. You will do something to accuse you.
Yes.
They will only do something to bring you down. To bring you down. But the Bible says that day, Jesus shut them up. Listen, you don't negotiate with accusers. You shut them up. You shut that spirit, accusing spirit that is working in their mind. Every accusing spirit against your new beginning.
Amen.
By the power in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, tonight they are shut up forever. Amen. I said they are shut up forever. Amen. And the last enemy of new beginning, we call them mockers. Metro. Ross, it be Metro. Beware of mockers.
Yes, sir.
They are enemies of new beginning. They will say, which road? Go to here, fine.
And then they fight.
They will say then they fight. Amen.
Amen.
They will say remove that rod, remove the blue rod, put cream color. Ask them, ever since the other carpet has been there, what did they do? That is their destiny. They are mockers. Listen, you don't listen to the voice of mockers. If you listen to the voice of mockers, you won't proceed.
Yes.
There was a time in my life I was battling high level of spiritual battle. I said, God, anywhere I go, people start calling me, Shola, they say, you do the same thing. And I went to God crying. God said, what is wrong with you? He said, pray that the noise should come to continue. Because I am using the money to advertise.
Yes.
I'm speaking to somebody.
Yes. Preach.
We heard about you in California. No. I said, God said, oh, leave the noise. I am using the noise. They said, which person? What's wrong? What's your TV?
It's
fetish. It's technical, it don't know power, it's common night, it's technical, they will do everything God said, live there. That is their ministry. Mockers, Asorene, and Ilasorene, they don't go to the front, and it's a leader. That is their ministry. I said, God, but it's getting too much. The Lord said, the more the noise, the more the adverts. And I remember, anytime Chelsea is playing ball, that's my point. The time we start shouting, the opposition team start losing. Amen.
Amen.
I declare in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The noise that will take you to your place of glory, it will never cease.
Amen.
And lastly, secrets of new beginning. Lastly, number one, I have about seven, but I'm talking about two of them. Secrets. On the roadway to new beginning. Number one, to have new beginning. Romans chapter 12, verse 2. Romans chapter 12, verse 2. I'm trying to sum. I have seven. I want to take the best three.
And you shall come to this world.
That is it. Now you are there.
But be ye transformed to the.
Be ye transformed. With what?
Renewing of your mind.
Number one. That's enough. God bless you. Number one secret to new beginning, to new thing is what? Change your thoughts. Be renewed in your mind. Have a new mentality. Challenge every situation with new approach. Change your gear. Amen. Celestial, we have an old mentality. If you come to the church, sir, let us finish this. What you better be to go, sir? Because I didn't worship him, Baba now.
No.
It's the same God.
Preach.
They bring newness. They brought newness to their service. And they have started relating with them with new things. Now they are being explored.
Yes.
We are in 2016 and we still want to be practicing celestial of 1940. And you want to move forward into that. Be renewed in your mind.
Yes.
For you to start a new thing, then you need a new mind, a new thought, a new mentality.
Yes.
A new mentality.
Yes.
In America, especially because this is my constituency now, we are losing our youth. Why? Because we are too rigid.
Yes.
We are not open to new things. New things. Let's not bring in new ideas. Let's not bring in new ideas. Let us train our children. Let us train them to start doing new things for God.
Amen.
I was at home after my prayers. Just a click on the computer, and I will see what they are doing in the redemption camp live.
Yes.
What stops us from doing a live stream of a night, a powerful night like this?
Right.
What stops us from doing a live stream of our harvest? I will be so happy on Sunday if my father brings out his laptop, just click, and is watching the harvest of my church. I'll be happy. That is your now. That is life. Not that I said the DVD. Select, can't we do it? What is wrong with us? Why are we practicing religion and not Christianity? You can see, God is really secret now. I said, let us start new things. Whatever you profess is what you possess. Listen, there is money in celestial
church.
Amen. Listen, please, be here. Amen. Be here. There is money in celestial church.
Yes.
But we are not spending it towards the right channel.
God bless you.
Let me give you an example that there is money in celestial church and as much anybody can do. I pray for one brother in celestial contact with Lamoury. I prayed for him. So the Lord asked me to tell him this. I was started praying for 3 days. And when the Lord answered, that day that he will come, I was broke. And I said, sweetie, let me go out to hustle. Now, okay, if I can go out and come back with like $100 or $200. Not knowing that person has been calling my number. Sir, I must have won the yellow card point, hustling for nothing. And when I eventually picked his call, he said, I want to see you. And I drove, I said, come and meet me here. And he went to meet me, he came to meet me at that point. And he said, that thing that you told me that we prayed about three days ago, he said, I've seen the result. And he brought out the evidence. Oh, I got to miss you. I was shaking. I was hoping that let him go fast so I can open up again. And I said, God, let him not be $1. And when he left, I got the alarm to left and I opened the envelope. $100, $2,000. I prayed one prayer. God answered. Under 3 days, he came back to say thank you with $2,000 in celestial.
Yes.
We are not training them to give to God. We are not training them to see the light. We are not training them to see good things. You know what? People that are supposed to train with new things, new ideas, to use for the celestial of Christ, because we are tired of how we are practicing our select, they go to redeem. And when they are not giving us the select, they give them the gift. And because we are not teaching that new, this is part of new beginning. New beginning, listen. New beginnings is not for men to do. It's for celestial church. Especially celestial church in America. And because this is the credo of celestial church in America. And that is why the topic is here. New beginning is a message for every parish in America. We must start making a U-turn. Enough is enough. Let us bring new ideas.
Yes.
So that our youth can stay. They are tired of our old mentality.
Amen.
Listen, up to 2 minutes, I will start praying. We train them. We train them from cradle. I want to round up now. We train them from cradle. They go to high school, they go to college. They become nurses. They become nurses and medical doctors. And they come to celestial church of Christ. They see us as we react like hooligans in the church. Somebody is preaching, maybe saying no wrong thing, or you mention your name, and you try and say, no! We lack respect for God. And because of this disorderliness, their friend has invited them to other parishes that are not, other churches that I don't want to mention them. And they see the way they worship God with serenity and orderliness.
Yes.
And the next Sunday they come to their church, they see our parents fighting, our fathers fighting, and they say to themselves, I don't want to worship in this kind of church. Listen, when they were nobody, when they were in the middle school and elementary, we are the one that trained them in select. And when they graduate from college as a nurse, redeem, hijack them.
Yes.
Select, something is wrong with us. Redeem, hijack them. And when they start getting their bringing tithes of $5,000, tithes, just tithes, they get it to redeem.
Yes.
You know what? And because we are not looking at this, medical doctors, the lawyers, the great ones, when they become great, they say, oh, I can't worship here. They still go. They go to those churches. And they leave the ones They are refused to go to college. The ones in high school. The ones that work in Popeye. The ones that work in McDonald's. The ones that work in KFC. They leave those ones for us. That would have gone to KFC to fry chicken and cheese. But when you at him at that, he will not come to Fiji. He will not be sleeping. When you don't have to be frustrated, the nurses are blessed. It is only Popeye Popeye that's remain. It is time for me. Embrace new beginnings.
Yes.
Even in the prophetic office, enough is enough.
Yes.
Enough. Stop lying to people. Yes. Stop lying. If God did not show you anything, don't say you see anything.
Yes.
And you know what? It is not. Listen. I want to run up. At times, most times, it is not the fault of who the prophet. It is your fault.
Oh, yes.
You ask me to pray for you.
Yes.
You kneel down before me and pray for you. Make the soul work. And I want you to say, ah, share it. As you ask me. If God spoke to me about you, you don't need to ask me before I tell you. But the fact that I pray for you with my prophetic mind and anointing, your prayer is answered.
Yes.
If I want to go, let me go. Listen, but because some prophets don't even have this, they have lost it. And you pray, you ask them to pray for you, they pray. And they don't want to appear as if they have lost it. Even though they know inside of them that they have lost it. And they are going on their own way, gently. And
they
say, what do you see? I will say, I see a mountain. I see a moon. Am I? Romans chapter 12, verse 2. When we get home, he said, let us be renewed. And I can recommend it, Roman. God bless you. Thank you, Lord. Let us be renewed in our thinking. Let us be renewed. Prophet will be coming to church on Sunday. I am committed
to.
I want the church.
You mean the church?
I have Sunday.
Ask
my what was a prophet. Monday, Friday, Tuesday, Thursday. During the week, you did fast. Sunday that you are supposed to fast, to be in the spirit, you are drinking water. And at that, I feel like slapping, giving some people Holy Ghost slap, but I can't do it. Choirs in the church. In the morning. But yeah, they go to the 12 o'clock.
What you want to do?
What you want? You cannot fast. Go to other denominations. They do it with trembling. They do it with fear. Jesus is here.
Yes.
Let us teach our children. Jesus in your Pentecostal church, you have been forgotten for long. Jesus is here. Let us embrace that Jesus. Every new beginning starts from Jesus. And that's why in Genesis, when he said, in the beginning, God said, before nothing, we must introduce God. Let us embrace God in celestial church of Christ. Let us return back to God. So our new things can start. So our the glory that the Lord has promised us, so it can start manifesting. And let the church start manifesting.
Amen.
You want to pray prayer now. Want to pray about two prayers? And I'll ever make you body, it's okay. After Corey, I will teach you, they will say, You want a lot on me. A lot of boy shall die, shall he? You want a lot on me. A lot of boy, you want a lot on me. A lot of boy shall die, shall he? By shall he? By you, go on today. When I sing, repeat after me. Say, you are the Lord of me, go.
You are the Lord of me.
Again.
You are the Lord of me.
O Lord, who go to Israel, I shall repeat.
O Lord, who go to Israel, I shall
repeat. You are the Lord of me again.
You are the Lord of me.
O Lord, who go to Israel,
I shall
repeat.
You are the Lord of me.
What does not move you? It cannot move God. What does not move you? You're actually praying, you're not moving. Whatever does not move you, it cannot move God.
Listen, this world that we are in, the world is not commanded to release anything to you freely. You are commanded to go to the world and take whatever you want first for you. So this particular time, you have to take it. Are we ready to pray this prayer?
Yes.
Son, my Father and my God. You are not ready. Son, my Father and my God. Don't forget that tonight is a night of new beginnings. I'm telling you. I told my father, he said, new beginnings. It means things that will be renewed will be much.
Amen.
Are we ready now?
Oh, yes.
Shout, my Father and my God.
Tonight.
Replace.
Everything that is old.
In my life.
With new things.
Listen. I told you about my talking about this last talking about all right. And I told you how God replaced it with new things. And I love new things. This is my powerful friend here. Keep saying, Brashola, this man does not. My God is a big God. I want big things. I was driving, I left service here like 2 weeks ago. And on New Hampshire, I saw a car in front of me. When you see the stickers behind that car, you know that this car belongs to a pastor. And that man was there, and I moved closer. And when I was there, I said, God, as a shepherd, here on material, hear me. And I didn't tell him because if I told him, I'm more than going to be professional. I said, not get it. My God is a big God.
Yes, sir.
It's working for me. I say it and God performed it.
Yes.
Oh, Baba, be a fan. Yes,
so many years ago.
Oh, my fault, Shebo, yeah, Baba.
What has been written?
This is the end of new beginnings. Baba, your God will surprise them. Yeah. I thank God, why?
Do
not forget the prayer. Replace some people, they have testimony and they agree like this. Your testimony is old, you are supposed to have replaced it. You are living in a house, 4-bedroom. When Obama came in, when George Bush, Ronald Reagan,
When he was in power,
therefore they bought the TV.
Jimmy Carter.
Therefore they bought the TV. Listen. I preach reality. Until now, they still decorate their living room with that same TV. And you come to church. Listen, if you want to use it, go come back all this away. 2 weeks ago, my wife did not tell me. She went straight into my wardrobe. This trouser, they wear. This trouser, they wear.
Because with one child,
And I want you to focus your mind to everyone. Some people, Esa, some women, they have old womb. And they want children. Children is not coming because that womb is old. What's your age? When you come and perform, replacement. Are we ready to play now?
Yes.
Because I see God giving some of the new wombs. By next time, you are coming with your dress. Shout my father. In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
Let's say it is settled. One more prayer point, and I brought the microphone. I told us success to new beginning, new mentality. What the Caroma strength to
form?
New mind. As a shepherd, we are supposed to enter our church every service day, especially Sunday, and look at it and God, what is next? Carry new mentality. Be fed up of your present situation. Some of us shepherds, that's why I say us, I'm a shepherd. Some of us shepherds, we are so comfortable with the little that we have. And that is why, if you don't move, God will not move.
Yes.
If you don't move, God, you enter your church for the Sunday service, and you count just 10 congregations, and you are happy, you say no problem, something is wrong with you. Something wrong. God called you. And in your church, 10 members, men are like calling.
Real,
mental,
real,
mental,
real,
mental, real, mental, real, mental, real,